acceleration diagram. The velocity diagram has single component, so there is no problem. But the acceleration diagram has two component. Let us take this example, a ball hanging on rope. Here, to find an acceleration, you need to calculate two acceleration component. The first one, radial component, radial acceleration, the second one, tangential acceleration. Here, the important thing is the radial component always perpendicular to tangential component. You can find the radial component using this formula, v squared ba divided by ab. Similarly, you can find the tangential component using this formula, alpha into ab. To find the true acceleration, you need to find the resultant of tangential component and radial component like this. So ABA is the true acceleration of. So two things are very, very important. Point number one, the radial component is always perpendicular to tangential component. Point number two, for example, if the ball rotates at constant velocity, then omega is constant. In that case, angular acceleration alpha equal to d omega by dt, that is equal to zero. Then there is no need to find tangential acceleration. So tangential acceleration is zero for a link rotating at constant velocity. So the point number two is, normally there is no need to find tangential component for crank, because the crank rotates at constant speed in general. So the tangential acceleration of crank is equal to zero. That's why while drawing an acceleration diagram, we never draw a tangential component for crank if it is rotates at constant speed. Draw velocity and acceleration diagram for four bar mechanism P, Q or S. Here crank angle 60 degree. The given data are, the crank PQ rotates at 10 radian per second. So omega 10 radian per second. From that we can calculate velocity VB. So velocity VB equal to R into omega. Here radius, that is length of crank, PQ. So PQ into omega, PQ value 62.5, which is 0.0625 multiplied by 10. So you will get 0.625 meter per second. So this is velocity of crank. Now we need to find the velocity and acceleration for link QR RS. So this is QR. Here we need to find angular velocity as well as angular acceleration for connecting rod, as well as angular acceleration and angular velocity for rocker. So this is an objective of this problem. Let us draw one by one. Let us draw space diagram. Consider this sheet as A3. On left hand side I am going to draw configuration diagram, on right hand side I am going to draw velocity as well as acceleration diagram. First, draw a line of length 200 mm which represent PS. Then from point P, draw an inclined line which makes 60 degree with respect to PS. The length of the line 62.5. Then mark the point Q. Now from point Q, draw an arc of length 175 mm using compass. Then from point S, draw an another arc of length 112.5 mm. Here you can see that both arc will cut at a point, so that is nothing but point R. Now connect QR and RS. Here one of the important thing is, it is very difficult to draw 200 mm, that is 20 centimeter on A3 sheet. So you can reduce this scale factor, but there is no need to mention that scale factor in the diagram. Here the scale factor is 200 divided by 2. Similarly here, divided by 2, divided by 2, divided by 2. But while writing, you can write it as 200 itself, because we are not going to use this length elsewhere. So let me draw the velocity component for each link. So link 1, PQ. So draw a line perpendicular to PQ. This is what law of relative velocity says, that velocity always perpendicular to link. You can use downward direction or upward direction, any direction, that is no problem. So this is velocity of Q. There is no need to mention P, which is fixed. Next, I am going to draw a velocity component for QR, which is perpendicular to link QR. Either you can use upward direction or downward direction. Then velocity component for RS, which is perpendicular to RS. That's it. So this is VR. So now I finished my configuration diagram. Velocity diagram. Step 1, identify fixed point. Here P and S are fixed. So this is my fixed point. Step 2, move the velocity of known component from configuration diagram to velocity diagram. Here the velocity of VQ is known value. The VQ, velocity of VQ, we already find in the given data, which is 0.625 meter per second. So using a roller scale, move this velocity component from this point to velocity diagram like this. So this is a direction of velocity component. We can fix the magnitude of this component because it is a known component. Here it is very difficult to mention meter per second in paper. So we assume 0.625 meter per second as 6.25 centimeter, which, so that I can mark this line as 6.25 centimeter. So measure 6.25 centimeter and mark it as Q. There is a reason why I am using 6.25. You can use any value between 4 to 8. Because these values are comfortable value. Since we are using a 3 sheet, this will give you a proper value. But you can use any value. The reason for using exactly 6.25 in the remaining conversion, for example, 1 centimeter equal to 0.625 divided by 6.25. So I will get 0.1 meter per second. So the remaining conversion will be easier. So without using calculator, I can do that. So that's why I am using 6.25 centimeter, because it's just a scale factor. The scale factor says the value that you can draw on a given space in your sheet. Okay, so this is what I am using here. Next, step 3, move a remaining velocity component. So I'm going to move the green color line VRQ, which is connected to point Q. So I'm going to move this green line to point P using roller scale. You can use roller scale. So here it is an animation, but you can use roller scale. Next, I am going to move the last line, that is blue line VR, which is connected to S. So here I have S. So I'm going to move this blue line to S. Okay, now that green and blue line will cut at your point. So this is nothing but my R. So now measure PR. Then PQ. If you measure, you will get VRQ as 3.33 centimeter. Then VRS as 4.26 centimeter. So this is in centimeter. Again, you need to convert that centimeter into meter per second. For that, you have to multiply each centimeter by 0.1 meter per second. So this will be 0.426 meter per second. This will be 0.33 meter per second. Then you have to mark arrow mark. So arrow mark always away from fixed point. So this is my fixed point. So this is my arrow mark. It will be like this. So this is VQ. There is no need to mention fixed point. This is VR. But this one is VRQ. So that's it. So this is velocity diagram. I'm going to use these values to calculate the angular velocity of given link. Subdivision 1, angular velocity of connecting rod. Formula, velocity divided by corresponding link. So velocity of connecting rod 3.333 centimeter multiplied by scale factor 0.1 divided by 175. You will get 1.9 radian per second. Then answer for second subdivision, angular velocity of rocker, which is equal to velocity of rocker divided by length of the rocker. So we already measured VRS as 4.26 centimeter in the previous slide. So 4.26 into scale factor 0.1 divided by the length of the rocker, you will get 3.728. Next, acceleration diagram. As I said already, acceleration component diagram has two components, radial and tangential. There is no need to find tangential because it is perpendicular to radial, so we focus only on radial component. Here we need to find three radial component because one link is fixed in 4-bar mechanism. So the radial component of crank, radial component of connecting rod, the radial component of rocker. So the formula to find radial component, velocity squared of corresponding link divided by corresponding link. So here velocity of crank we know that 0.625, then the link length 0.0625, you will get 6.25 meter per second square. This is radial component of QP. Then radial component of RQ 0.33 square divided by 0.175. here you have that value VRQ. Here you have VRS value. So in that way you can find radial component of each link. With this data, let us draw an acceleration diagram. This is a same configuration diagram where here I removed only the velocity component to get clear idea, but you can directly draw this diagram on the you have already drawn velocity diagram. Okay, we focus only on radial component. So first let me draw the radial component PQ, which is parallel to link. So draw a line like this, which is parallel to PQ, AQ of radial component. Then radial component of QR radial component of RS always along the direction of RS. Then the radial component of RQ along the link RQ. There is no need to draw a tangential component, which is understandable. That is, radial component, tangential component always perpendicular to radial. Acceleration diagram. Step 1, identify fixed point. Here it is P, S. Step 2, identify the known acceleration from configuration diagram to acceleration diagram. Here it is AQ. So I'm going to move AQ to acceleration diagram using roller scale. The value of ARQ equal to 6.25 meter per second. We assume 6.25 meter per second is 6.25 centimeter. So let me fix it here. So this is 6.25 centimeter. There is no need to find tangential component for PQ because the tangential component is equal to 0. Here the crank rotate at constant velocity, so acceleration equal to 0. Hence there is no need to find tangential component for PQ. So I can consider this ARQ as a true acceleration. Next, step 3. Move radial component of unknown values. Now I am going to move this blue color line from point R to Q because the point R connected to Q. The magnitude of radial component which I calculated already is 0.634 meter per second. 0.634 equal to 0.634 meter per second. So this is 0.634 centimeter. This is a radial component. Then a tangential component always perpendicular to radial component. So draw a line perpendicular to this ARQ, which is nothing but tangential component. So this is tangential component of RQ. Next, step 4, I am going to move this green color line, that is AR of RQ, which is connected to point S. So I am going to move this green color line to point S like this. Again, the magnitude of ARR is 1.613. This is also we already calculated a radial of rocker. Now I can fix this point. This is ARQ. Again, draw a tangential line, a perpendicular line to AR of RS. So this is a tangential component of RS. Now you can see both tangential line will cut at a point. So this point is nothing but R. Now I can connect P, Q, R, S. So this pink color line represent the true acceleration of each link. So this is a true value of RS, that is a rocker, and this one is a true value of QR. So in this problem, subdivision 3 and 4 are angular acceleration of connecting rod and rocker. For that I need tangential value. So measure this value, a tangential of RQ and a tangential of RS, that is this dot dot line from this point to this point, again from this point to this point. If you measure ARQ, you will get 4.1 centimeter. If you measure a tangential of RS, you will get 5.3 centimeter. So from this diagram, I'm going to use only these two parameter. Here these values are in centimeter, which you have to multiply it with meter per second in order to convert a proper scale factor. Here when you multiply that with scale factor, you will get a tangential of RQ equal to 4.1 meter per second square, a tangential of RS equal to 5.3 meter per second square. So subdivision 3 is to find angular acceleration of connecting rod alpha RQ. For that formula, ATRQ divided by RQ. Here we already have ATRQ, then RQ value 0.175. So finally you will get 23.43 radian per second square. Similarly, you can find angular velocity or angular acceleration of rocker, which is 47.1 radian per second. So this is a simple acceleration diagram for four bar mechanism. Thank you for watching my video.